Hi everyone, welcome to Rosie's Dessert Spot. Today I wanted to demonstrate how to create a gold drip using chocolate rather than ganache. I know typically a lot of people would go for the ganache option. The problem with that is though that it doesn't set quite firm enough for you to be able to paint it without messing the consistency or the look of the drip. Sometimes you can create little brush indentations. Or you can see the texture of the actual paintbrush as it passes over the ganache. Whereas if you use white chocolate, you will not come across that problem. You can apply as much pressure as you want while you paint without running the risk of damaging your drip. So I've started with a 6-inch cake. This was just a vanilla cake, I believe, with vanilla buttercream. And then for that ombre look, I'm taking two differently colored pinks, so like a dark pink and a light pink, and just applying it in different areas of the cake. I also went in with a little bit of white just to help create a little bit more of an ombre effect, and then smoothed it all out. From here you can clean up the top edge of your frosting and then set your cake in the fridge for about half an hour. You can apply some gold leaf onto your cake while it's still a little bit wet, or if you did pop it into the fridge, no stress. If it doesn't want to stick, just add a little bit of water with a brush. This is melted white chocolate. You can see here I've added some vegetable oil, and then I've added even more vegetable oil. Basically, you just want it to be really runny so that it actually drips down the side of the cake. Problem is with white chocolate, if you've just melted it and added it directly onto the cake, problem is sometimes it doesn't quite drip down the sides and it looks really bulky and thick and just not very nice looking. So to about 2 cups worth of melted chocolate, I added about 1/2 cup worth of oil. Then I popped it into a piping bag, made a little disc of chocolate at the top, and then very quickly you want to shake your turntable to settle that chocolate so you can't really see the lines. And then artificially add those drips over the side. You want to work quickly, especially if your cake has just come out of the fridge, because it'll set your chocolate very fast. And then you can just leave your cake on the bench to set or pop it into the fridge to speed things up. This is edible gold luster dust that I'm adding with some vodka. If you can't use alcohol though, you can use oil, lemon juice, or vinegar. White vinegar will work as well. Once you've created a nice thick paint, take a brush and brush it over your chocolate. You can allow this to set, let the alcohol evaporate, and then go on with a second coating of that paint. There are flowers that are being pressed into this because it's chocolate. If you were to just press the flower in, you could risk cracking your drip. So create a little hole first by screwdriving a knife through that chocolate to make a hole for your flower. I hope this video was helpful. Feel free to subscribe for more cake decorating content, and we'll catch you again in the next one.